But actually, these issues are so important because they're about where billions and billions of our pounds are going to go. Are they going to go into renewable energy? Are they going to go into making our homes energy efficient? Or are they going to go into enriching nuclear corporations while the public pick up the tab and the future generations deal with the waste? Those decisions are being made now, and that's why I think we need to make a decision. So I've written this song, and it's called Mr. Magical Molecule. Reversing down the cul-de-sac.
Beep, beep, beep.
Now Rex to Nagasaki on the back of an unmarked truck on the open road. Looking for somewhere to dump his load. Now he's pulling up outside. Quick, everybody, find somewhere to hide. Remember, he made us all ill. The day he come over from Chernobyl. Now he's as green as a cobra. That's what I call a makeover. Man with a clean lick of paint. And him with a glow of a left day saint. Master of spin, pour the cans or let him back in. When all that he has is a grin, something he got from a hazardous waste. In sure, I knew you, Mr. Magical Molecule, saw right through you. Magical, not ecological. Guess who's knocking at the door? Ring it for the fella that come here before, selling the atomic fuel. Mr. Magical Molecule, we sent him packing last week. He said he just needed a tweak. But didn't the steam start to leak? And didn't he dump all his crap in the drink? Though whether the neighbours got burned, I can't believe he's returned. After he melted a hole in the floor, we told him to never come back anymore. I'm sure I knew you, Mr. Magical Molecule, saw right through you. Magical, but not ecological. Guess who's ringing on the bell? Pretending he's someone else who wants me to cut my emissions. By adopting a fission position in just a decade or two, we're gonna save CO2 in just a decade or four. It still isn't built, and he's asking for more. Another 10 years to wait for reactions too little, too lethal, too late. Just leaving the sun in the sky. I'll find a way to get by, Mr. Magical Molecule. Hanging around with the same spent fuel, tragicomical killer jewels. That's Mr. Magical Molecule. Now he's kneeling at the letterbox. Thank heaven we changed all the locks. He whispers he'll do me a favour. But not to tell my Iranian neighbour. We switch from fossil to fissile. We'll get a nuclear missiles. Megatons more than I need. But at least I can stay in the lead. With my atoms for peace armory. And additional bills for the home security. Terrorists try to get in. And me with a shed full of terrible toxins. Long after concrete has crumbled. Pray that it still won't be rumbled. Kids of the future, remember. Never to break it or blow on the embers. Down in the sand that's so dry. Subterranean waters will never run dry. If there's a crack in the land, a man with a lab coat will always be on hand. Oh, oh, Mr. Magical Molecule, I don't think so. Magical, not ecological. Stop, don't pick up the phone. Ringing to check if the kids are home alone. Wait till they get a seat to windows. Then open a window for the wind scale swindle. Says he might have to look. Have a look. They'll never know he's a crook.
Is it crook?
It's only after they're hooked. They'll discover it's more than the books that are cooked. He's a regular scabies attack. A horrifying zombie that keeps coming back. I haven't got time for this. Somebody's taking the... With a same spent fuel, tragicomical killer tools. This Mr. Magical Molecule. I don't know you are the comeback kid who hit one in a $1 trillion dustbin. You got a scene of plastic ecologist for your PR. Ecologist, but you're a working dad man, not a bad man, maybe a sad man, surely a sad man. One of the last man to follow the fat man, a concrete pad and a thousand rags man. And they'll be made perfectly clear. We don't want your background here. Now I don't need to take another. Who's that tapping at the window? Mr. Magical GMO. just mention on that. Oh, sorry, yeah, more on that. Just want to mention, yeah, like the return of the nuclear power zombie undead, there is also the repair of the GM, the return of the GMO, and governments in the EU are trying to push that through now. We're talking about particularly genetically modified cooking oil. There is a campaign. They want to put, oh, I don't know, I can't read the whole announcement, but basically it's really important to get up there and find out, if you remember the battle over GMOs, get up to the store, the GMO store up there. There's Liz at the back. She's standing up now. Have a look around there. That's Liz. She's a great woman. She's got leaflets all about what's going on with the old GMOs. We're just having a little mic change here. Can I just say then, while she's changing the mic, I just want to make a little announcement, which is, if you, this is particularly this song, which is a love song, which is a really, I'm going to encourage you, when Ali does this song, Big Love, that you look at other people and look them in the eyes and you say Big Love, and look at a complete stranger and say Big Love, so that you start falling in love with people you don't know. That's really nice. When you decide and you go back and maybe you end up in a tent that wasn't your own, it's very important, particularly if you're in the performers area, that you go home first and turn off your alarm clock. Otherwise, beep, at 6 in the morning, beep, we'll have an alarm clock waking up everyone, and you won't be in your tent. And we'll be knocking and knocking. You won't be there. Okay. Ready?
Okay, Big Love, let's do it. Okay, sing along to this one. Can you get any Everett hands in the air? Just need Theo to start and we'll be off.
I can't feel it. Big love.